I've had a very interesting week since my talk with Birch. It's kind of weird, but while Birch's advice didn't really change anything that's been happening lately, I still felt a bigger sense of comfort having talked to him than I have in quite a while. The day we visited my mom's grave together helped too. While it's true we couldn't change the fact that the marker was chipped and cracked in places, it was still nice to see it without all the garbage all over it. And even then, when we left, Birch told me not to worry because he had an idea for something he was going to do that would make me smile. I have no idea what he meant by that, but I trust Birch now more than just about anyone, so I'm sure that whatever he's planning is going to be a nice surprise. Today was even more interesting, though. I decided to go for a walk to a nearby park to get some fresh air, as I hadn't been outside much after the last talk with Birch. When I got there, I headed over to the water fountain to get a drink. As I turned around, though, intent on heading to the small hiking trail in the park, I didn't expect to see what I did.
Yeah, I'll get the ball. Sheesh.
What the? Hey, don't run out into the...
Whoa there. You okay, buddy?
Yeah, I think so.
Traffic around here is way too dangerous to run out in the street like that. And next time, remember to look both ways or get a grown-up to help you, okay?
Sorry. Thanks for saving me.
Yeah, no trouble at all, little man. Just stay safe out there, all right?
I will, sir.
Phew, well, that was too close.
Mr. Grizzly?
Look, I was just saving the kid from getting hit by... Oh, God. Oh, God, no. What are you doing here?
I live a few blocks from here. I saw what you just did.
I wasn't gonna do nothing to him. I swear. I just didn't want him getting
you
hit.
You just saved that kid's life. That was really brave.
I'm working on trying to make up for stuff I've done to people in the past, and... I gotta ask, though, why on earth would you want to talk to me, huh? Knowing what happened the last time we saw each other?
I remember what happened, but the fur I saw back then doesn't seem like the same fur I just saw saving that kid.
What do you mean?
You risked your own life just to save someone else's. You can't fake that. It's just like that day in the hotel room. Before Bert showed up, you seemed to care more about yourself than anything or anyone else. But afterward, it was like you'd suddenly been scared out of your mind. It seemed like you became a completely different person.
Yeah, well, you're one of the very few who believes that.
What do you mean?
Forget about it, okay? There's no way you can understand.
It can't hurt to try, Grizz.
Wally, please, Wally, please. Call me Stan, okay?
Now I was sure I was talking to someone different. I still remember how he greeted me the last time.
Thank you for offering to teach me, Mr. Grizzly.
Oh, please, just call me Grizz, and... Pleasure's all mine.
He asked me to call him Grizz before, but now he seemed frightened that I had. Something had definitely changed. Okay, so, Stan, tell me, what did you mean I'm one of very few that believes that?
Well, do you know why I was so horrified when I saw Birch that day?
No, I just assumed back then that you were scared because someone saw you.
Well, it wasn't the fact that someone saw me, it was the fact he saw me.
Huh?
Well, did Birch ever tell you he and I used to be friends?
No, but he didn't have to. Remember, I've been following Birch's music for a long time. I know you two were bandmates.
We were a lot more than that. All I'm going to say is that I grew to care about him a great deal. I grew to...
To love him?
Well, I wouldn't say love it, at least not in that respect, but... Well, one day I did something really stupid that ruined our relationship, and both as bandmates and as friends, and Birch still hasn't forgiven me for it.
But what about that appearance in Rock Band Wars? I saw you two hug.
No, that was just for show, Wally. And I knew that. Birch isn't dumb enough to make himself look like a jerk with thousands of fans watching.
Oh. Why can't you just go to him and apologize?
Well, I tried it. Just yesterday, in fact. Didn't go very well.
Hey, wait a second. Stan, don't you live in Portsmouth? If you were visiting Birch yesterday, you obviously drove here, but then why are you still here? Why didn't you go home?
Well, I did go home. I came back today because I wanted to try again, but... I just don't have it in me to stand there and have Birch slam the door in my face again. Next time he does that, it could be for good.
I don't think Birch would do that. He's not that mean.
Nah, I can't risk that. If I try to approach him again, he may take out a restraining order against me. And I wouldn't put it past him to do that.
At this point, I now knew something I was only guessing at before. They did care about each other, but now it appears they're avoiding each other. Birch has been helping me for the last year. It's about time I help someone else, too. As luck would have it, I'd been watching one of my favorite talk shows last week, and I remembered the host mentioning that this week there was supposed to be a special guest. That special guest was supposed to be Stan. I knew the show was being taped in a TV studio nearby, and in the past, my father had got me passes so I could sit in the audience. True, I can't rely on my dad to help me here, but I had another idea. Hey, Stan?
Yeah?
Were you still planning to do that talk show appearance tomorrow?
Oh, you heard about that, huh? Well, I'm kind of regretting taking it, but I can't back out now, so I guess I am. Why do you ask?
What if I got Birch to show up?
Yeah, nice try, Wally. All you'd have to say is that I'm the guest, and he won't set foot anywhere near the studio.
What if I didn't tell him you were there?
Oh, Wally, you'd know that'd be dishonest.
I'm not gonna say you aren't there, but I won't say you are either.
He's gonna find out one way or another.
And I think I have a plan for that, too.
Okay. Still one small problem, though. Where are you gonna get the tickets?
I've been saving up my money from my allowance for a while now. I thought maybe I could buy a couple tickets at the door.
Well, that's just it. This close to the show, there may not be any tickets left. Although, if you are serious about this, I think I have a way around that.
I am. What did you have in mind?
Oh, please, God, don't let me regret this. Here. I was planning to throw these away, seeing as I couldn't think of anyone to give them to, but if you really think you can pull this off, you can have them.
Thank you, Stan.
One last question, though. Why are you helping me? You know what I almost did. Even I still think about it. Why would you help mend my friendship with Birch? This has nothing to do with you at all.
Actually, Stan, it kind of does. I won't lie, I still think about what happened too. But even when I was sitting in that hotel room scared, I couldn't help but notice the shouting didn't last very long. I have no idea what you two talked about, but something had to have happened that calmed Birch down again. He didn't look as mad when we left as he did when he got there.
Picked up on that, didn't you?
Yes, I did. I'm pretty sure all you'd need is a chance to show Birch you've changed, just like you showed me. This would give you that chance.
Yeah, well, what makes you so sure he won't do what he did with Rock Band Wars and just put on another show for the cameras?
Simple. Whether he hates you or not, he's proven on more than one occasion that he wants to help me. If I tell him I've been thinking about what happened back then, and I tell him I thought that this might be a good way to help the three of us, I'm willing to bet he'll do it, if only because he wants me to feel better. And I'm sure it'll help him better understand you, too.
Well, don't you think that's a bit, manipulative?
Do you have a better idea?
No, I can't say that I do. But forgive me if I don't have the same confidence as you.
It's better than not trying, Stan. If you don't try, then it can never get better.
I don't know if it can get better. Look, Wally, you don't know how lucky you are. You've had it rough, I know, but there are far worse things that can happen to a kid.
Like what?
I can't tell you because I don't really recall it myself. Something happened back when I was your age that, well, it was so bad I blocked it from my memory. Well, I know it's still there, it's just not in my memory anymore.
I don't understand.
Neither do I, Wally. Best way I can put it is I have a missing person inside me, and I won't be whole until I find him again.
Another question in me, one for the powers that be. It's gotten thrown in, so I put on my poker face and try to figure it out, this undeniable doubt. A common occurrence, feeling so out of place. Guarded and cynical now, can't help but wondering how my heart evolved into a rock beating inside of me. So I reel, such a stoic ordeal. Where's that feeling that I don't feel? There was a boy who had the faith to move a mountain, and like a child he would believe without a reason. Without a trace he disappeared into the void, and I've been searching for that missing person. Under a lavender moon, so many thoughts consume me. What dim the glowing light that once burned so bright in me? Is this a radical phase, a problematical age that keeps me running from all that I used to be? Is there a way to return? Is there a way to unlearn that carnal knowledge that's chipping away at my soul? Have I been gone too long? Will I ever find my way home? There was a boy who had faith to move a mountain, and like a child he would believe without a reason. Without trace, he disappeared into the void, and I've been searching for that missing person. He used to want to try to walk the straight and narrow. He had a fire and he could feel it in the marrow. It's been a long time and I haven't seen him lately, but I've been searching for that missing person. For that missing person. For that missing person. Child, he would believe without a reason. Without a trace, he disappeared into the void. And I've been searching. He used to want to try to walk the straight and narrow. He had a fire and he could feel it in the marrow. It's been a long time and I haven't seen him lately, but I've been searching for that missing person. Where are you? Oh, I've been searching for that person. Where are you? Oh,